Since last few weeks, ChatGPT has taken the world by storm. It's all over in LinkedIn feed, Twitter, YouTube, and everywhere. You may already know that GPT-3 stands for Generative Pre-trained Transformer 3 and is a large language AI model. It is so capable and trained that it can compose essays and poetry for you and can also provide almost working code snippet. We think that's cool, and what would have been even cooler is to build the voice bot using it. We saw several examples of text-based chatbots, but we wanted to build a voice-based AI conversationalist. So here we go. On a high level, when user dials into our application, caller utterance, which is an audio stream, is converted to text using transcription service, which is nothing but speech-to-text conversion. This user utterance text is sent to ChatGPT API, which responds according to the user input. We then convert this response text to audio and playback to the caller. The architecture diagram here talks about various components and APIs used to achieve this functionality. Let's look at those one by one. Before we move on, please take a look at these prerequisites. We have Twilio platform to provide the voice channel. You need to sign up on twilio.com and create a trial account, which provides you a sandbox-like environment. You can also troubleshoot, manage, and develop applications in the sandbox. Once you have created the account, you can use Twilio console to buy a phone number. This is the phone number which caller will dial to talk with your voice bot or IVR application. So, if you are using a trial account, it will play a disclaimer like, this is a trial account, every time you make a call to the Twilio provided phone number. You cannot barge into this prompt. If you wish to get rid of this message, you need to upgrade your account and you will be charged as per their pricing model. Now, if you see here, we have a telephony voice interface module. This module comprises of integration between Twilio platform and Java application. This Java application needs to be internet-facing. You can do this by using ngRock. ngRock is a utility which exposes your local application to the internet. It's very easy to use. It provides you with a URL which you can use from anywhere to access your local applications. You can visit ngRock.com for documentation and for downloading ngRock. Once you have the ngRock URL, you need to configure your application URL in Twilio's webhook settings. When caller dials the phone number, it will invoke your application using the configured webhook. This Java application, which gets invoked from Twilio, is developed using Spark framework. Spark allows compact coding and it starts super fast. In this Java application, we use TVML. That is Twilio markup language for generating the user experience. For example, collecting user input or playing prompt to the caller. To use TVML, you need to use Twilio SDK. Twilio SDK supports variety of programming languages like Java, C#, Node.js, PHP, Python, Ruby, and Go. You can use the SDK based on your language of expertise. Here, we have chosen Twilio's Java SDK. For more details on Twilio SDK, please visit www.twilio.com/docs/libraries. Now, let's talk about the transcribe module. As we need to send text input to OpenAI's completions API for conversation, we need to convert caller's voice input into text first. For this, we have written a sample Python program which uses OpenAI's Whisper APIs for transcription. This Python program takes a WAV or MP3 file as an input and passes it to Whisper API, which returns transcription of the input audio. Now comes the conversation driver, OpenAI's completions API. It provides access to GPT, which allows us to have conversation between the bot and the caller. We now have the user utterance or user's questions in text format, and it's time we start having conversation with the bot. We simply consume completions API, passing important request parameters like model name, prompt, temperature, max tokens, etc. Let's look at these request parameters. We are using DaVinci model. There are some other models like ADA, Babbage, and Curie. Prompt is the user input. Temperature can be anything between 0 to 1. 1 means your bot will be more creative in forming responses, while lower number ensures that the bot provides only the well-defined answers. This means that bot will provide the same answer every time the same input is supplied. We have used 0.9 because we like creativity. Finally, token is nothing but the number of words to be written in the response. Once the API call is successful, you can extract the response text from choices object of the API response. In GPT world, this response is called as completions. Now that we have the completions text, we will use TweeML to construct the audio response, which will be played back to the caller. Since it's a dynamic response, we are using Amazon Polly for text-to-speech conversion. For the complete demo, you can visit our previous video, which contains the sample interaction between the caller and the voice bot. Link is in the description below. So that's all for now. We will see you in the next video. Bye-bye.